After some partial successes and several failures and several spools of TPU, I finally have a pair of 3D printed shoes, and we'll talk about them right after this. I'm Brian, and you are watching BV3D. Hello, 3D printing friends, and welcome back. I'm going to talk about shoes and filament and failure and success. And before you decide to comment that I'm taking too long to get to whichever part of the video you're most interested in, use the chapter markers that I've added to get to whichever part of the video you're most interested in. It'll save you from having to add a comment, and it'll save me from having to reply to your comment to tell you to use the chapter markers. Okay, so today I'm showing off these cool 3D printed shoes. I downloaded and printed these myself, and if you've got a printer big enough, you can do it too. I will warn you, though, that I didn't have immediate success. Well, I did, but then I had a series of failures, and those failures really kept me on my toes. At times, I wanted to give up, but after doing some soul searching, I decided I wasn't going to just loafer around, and eventually I was able to troubleshoot the problems. But enough of these puns. Let me show you where you can get these shoes. You can download these for free from MakerWorld, courtesy of Makerverse Designs, and there's a link in the description. When you download them, you can get them as 3MF files that will open up right in Bamboo Studio, or you can get them as STL files you can open in any slicer. There's a scaling guide you can use to figure out what percentage to scale the shoes to fit your feet. It's in EU sizing, so you'll probably need to actually measure your foot in centimeters and pick your size based on that. That's what I had to do, and I ended up at a scaling value of 111% to get a good fit. But it took me a few attempts to discover that perfect for me size, and we'll get to that in a couple of minutes. First, though, I want to talk about filament. I bought and went through nearly 3 spools of black Overture TPU with various successes and failures. And I began to realize that it might get costly to foot the bill to keep the quest for 3D printed shoes going, so I reached out to Polymaker, who sponsored this episode with a couple of spools of their Polyflex TPU 90. This is available in 750-gram spools in black, white, gray, clear, and Polymaker teal. I chose the Polymaker teal. I figured if they were going to help me out with a couple of spools of filament, I was darn sure going to show off their signature color. So, where the Overture and most other brands of TPU have a shore hardness of 95, the TPU 90 has a shore hardness of 90. Lower shore hardness numbers mean a softer, more flexible filament. Polymaker also has TPU 95, and it's available in more colors: black, white, blue, red, yellow, and orange. But if I was going to print these shoes in Polymaker teal, I was going to have to print them in TPU 90 because that's the only TPU they make in that color. And now, join me as we parade past the lost souls on the winding path to printing success. The first time I tried to print these, I scaled the shoe a little bit too small to be comfortable. And the problem is, you won't know it's too small or too large until you've printed an entire shoe, and printing an entire shoe takes the better part of a day. So this was the first one that came out a tiny bit too small. And apart from the size, it actually printed really well. Now, this was done in that black Overture TPU I mentioned earlier. I printed it on the Soval SV08, sliced with Orca Slicer, and like I said, it took a while to print. Now, TPU isn't really a filament you can rush. Now, funny enough, it printed successfully without supports at this angle. But there was quite a bit of stringing on the inside. It was easy enough to reach in and grab the stringy bits and pull them out. I thought that was just a result of the TPU needing to be dried. So I adjusted the scale and tried again. This time I underestimated how much filament I had left. What that means is I ran out about halfway through this second print. But the SV08 paused the print job when the filament ran out, so I ran out to Amazon to order another spool, which got here the next day. And yes, I just left the printer sitting there running that whole time until I could load in the new filament. And believe it or not, it actually resumed without much of an issue. You can see this one line on the print where it started up again, and the color of the filament on the second spool was a little darker than the first. But it did complete successfully, and it fit. So now I had two 3D printed shoes. So now I had two 3D printed shoes, but one was a little bit too small. so I had to reprint the smaller one at the slightly larger scale. On the first two shoes, the settings in Orca Slicer had it doing Z-hop, where it lifts the tool head slightly before moving to another part of the print. Since Z-hop can contribute to stringing, I thought it would be a good idea to disable Z-hop to try to reduce that. So with that disabled, I reprinted the too small shoe. And turning off Z-hop did, in fact, reduce the stringing. Unfortunately, the tool head started running into the model, and eventually it managed to knock the front cover, the part with the cooling fan, completely off the tool head, so I had to stop the print. And this is that shoe. It was doing great up until that point, so I tried again. This time, a little later than the last time, the nozzle tripped on the model again, and it knocked the fan loose again, but I wasn't around to notice, so I wasn't able to stop the print. It completed, but it was hardly a success. So I tried again. This time, when the nozzle hit the model, I got a layer shift. I saw that one, and so shortly after it happened, I was able to stop it. At this point, I got discouraged, and I put this whole project on the shoe rack for a little while. And then once some time had passed, I tried again. This time, I did it on my Bamboo Lab P1P, since I don't have an AMS unit connected to it. The model, scaled for my feet, just barely fit in the printer's 256mm cubed build volume after adjusting the angle on it slightly. I thought I was going to be tempting fate, printing the softer TPU90 instead of the TPU95, but I was very pleasantly surprised. I just used Bamboo Studio's generic TPU filament settings, and because this TPU is softer, I chose to use the 3MF file that had supports enabled on specific parts of the shoe. To me, the TPU settings seemed better tuned using the Bamboo Lab printer with Bamboo Studio Slicer than they did for the Soval SV08 in Orca Slicer. Now that's not a knock against the SV08 or Orca Slicer, it's just an observation. So I switched filament, I switched slicers, and I switched printers. And finally, after 33 hours of print time, I got a pair of shoes. So let's get a closer look at these. There are a couple of areas that have slight problems. On this one, there's a little bit of a line where the nozzle was pushing the model out of the way because that particular part of the model is relatively thin and easily nudged. On this one part here, the top surface of both of them has a slightly bubbled appearance. I think if I add an extra top layer in the print settings, it might solve that issue. And there are lots of little loops on the sole where the overhang angle on the tread pattern just didn't work out with the angle that the shoe printed at. Now that didn't happen quite as much on the black ones, but I don't know if that's due to the filament or due to the fact that the black ones printed at a more upright angle. But there wasn't any stringing on these Polymaker shoes, and overall I'm really happy with how these turned out. Now, aside from the struggles I had just to get a pair of these shoes printed, the second hardest problem with them was getting the straps connected. The pins on these cone-shaped connectors kept breaking along the layer lines. So here's my pro tip. Print one of the cone-shaped connectors and perform this test. Pinch the two pins together. If it breaks, try a different filament. The first filament I was trying to use was a really nice stark white color, but it wasn't all that strong. This less stark, more milky white filament, it's AnchorMake PLA Plus, by the way, while not as pretty, was strong enough to pass the pinch test, so I was able to snap the two halves of the strap connectors together without breaking them. It did take a lot of force, though. Now, you might be wondering how comfortable these are. I wondered the same thing, so I took these shoes for a test walk down to the mailbox to see how they feel. It wasn't far, only about half a block. Printed in the TPU90, I found them to be soft and squishy, maybe a little too soft, but still comfortable. I'm not sure if I'd spend a whole day in them, but for around the house, working in the yard, or going to get the mail, they're not terrible. And they're 3D printed, so they've got that going for them, which is nice. I think if I were to print another pair, I would definitely add another perimeter or two in the settings, and another top and bottom layer. And I'd maybe bump up the infill percentage just a little bit. But they're not bad to wear. Something else you probably want to know is, are these 3D printed shoes cost effective? Well, a pair of these, scaled to fit my big old feet, weigh in at just under 500 grams. So there's enough on these 750 gram spools for a pair of shoes, plus at least one nearly complete mistake. A 750 gram spool of Polymaker's Polyflex TPU 90 cost $40 US, so you're looking at $40 a pair for this style of shoe. That's a little less than the actual retail price from a major brand and about what you'd pay for that brand on Amazon. Given the time, effort, energy, and filament I spent on this project, well, I probably would have been better off just buying a pair of the real thing. Using a less expensive TPU will, of course, reduce the cost of producing your own footwear. And now that I've got the experience of doing it, the next time I print a pair, I'm sure they'll cost less than the real thing. That said, I don't know what the long-term durability of these is going to be, but I suspect that just for wearing around the house or whatever, they'll probably be okay. When these eventually break or wear out or whatever, I'll post an update in the community tab here on the channel, unless they fail in some spectacular way that seems to warrant a video. So yay, I finally managed to 3D print some shoes, and I managed to do it in a more flexible than usual TPU. Okay, well, thank you for watching. There were a lot of puns, but they weren't the sole purpose of the video. I also wanted to share my story of success. Big thanks to everyone who supports the channel, whether with channel memberships or by using the links in the description. If you liked this episode, give it a thumbs up and maybe consider subscribing so you don't miss new ones. Well, 3D printing friends, that's about all the time we have for this one. And now that we're at the end, let's go print something cool.